Hello friends, in this video we are going to see how the low voltage low current regulator is designed and how it is implemented, how it works. So let's begin with the topic. Low voltage low current regulator is basically designed by using IC723. IC723 is basically a general purpose regulator. It provides a wide voltage range that is from 2 volt to 37 volt. It provides a maximum load current of 150 milliampere. Now let's see how the circuit of low voltage low current regulator looks like. The low voltage low current regulator basically used to provide load voltage of 2 to 7 volt. And the load current is nothing but 150 milliampere. And therefore, the circuit is called as low voltage, low current regulator. Now, let's have a look of the circuit diagram. Now, from the circuit diagram, we will come to know that the resistor R1 and resistor R2 forms a voltage divider between V reference and ground. And therefore, the voltage across resistor R2 is given as V non-inverting, that is nothing but voltage at pin number 5, and it is nothing but the voltage developed across resistor R2. V non-inverting is equals to R2 upon R1 plus R2 into V reference. Now let's go back to the circuit diagram. Now we know that internally the IC723 consists of error amplifier, and as the gain of error amplifier is very high, therefore we can say V non-inverting is equals to V inverting. Moving back to the circuit diagram, the regulated output voltage which is available at inverting pin through a resistor R3 and RAC is now equal to the value of V inverting. Therefore, we can say the output voltage is given as VO, that is output voltage, is equals to V non-inverting, that is nothing but the voltage applied across resistor R2, equals to R2 upon R1 plus R2 into V reference. Moving back to the circuit diagram, from the circuit diagram we will come to know that the resistance RAC is nothing but the current limiting resistance or current sensing resistor. The resistor RAC is connected between the current limit and current sensing. Now, the value of resistor R1 and R2 is in the range of 1 kilo ohms to 10 kilo ohms. The voltage developed or the current flowing through a resistance RAC is now proportional to the output voltage. And the value of RAC is given as RAC is equals to VAC upon I limit, which is equals to 0.6 upon I limit. Now, if the load current increases beyond the current limiting value, that means the I limit value, then the transistor Q2, which is called as current sensing transistor, is get turned on. As the transistor Q2 get turned on, it will rob off majority of the base current of transistor Q1. As base current of the transistor Q1 is get decreases, therefore its collector current is also get decreases. And this is called as short circuit protection. So, in this way, the current limiting value can be used to provide short circuit protection to the circuit. Now, moving back to the circuit diagram, the resistor R3 is given as a parallel combination of R1 and R2, and therefore the value of R3 is obtained as so R3 is equals to R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. As the circuit provides maximum load current of 150 milliampere and voltage between 2 to 7 volt, therefore the circuit is called as low current low voltage regulator. So this is how about the low voltage and low current regulator. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.